This was really one of the largest ever private investments.
Yeah, that's right. And it really vaults AI, or OpenAI rather, to one of the most valuable startups in the world. You're talking and putting it alongside SpaceX, for instance, TikTok owner ByteDance. But it just certainly tells you, to your point there, around one of the most valuable or highest ever valuation rounds, that the tech industry really believes in the power of AI. So some of the key details here. So it was led by the latest round by Thrive Capital. They tipped in around $1.3 billion. Microsoft, we're hearing, which is of course the biggest backer to date, about $750 million. Others, including Coastal Ventures, Tiger Global. In Asia, we were reporting SoftBank, for instance, or the information actually had this initially, but looking at handing over $500 million. So a lot of different really high profile names. It's then a question of how does OpenAI plan to use this cash? And what we're hearing from the company, because they put out a statement, is that they're looking at putting the funds toward AI research, adding compute capacity as well, because that's becoming quite a key issue now, just having enough computing power to power these AI tools. But certainly a huge valuation, and one that's really transfixing many in Silicon Valley.
We have heard warnings when it comes to these kinds of sky-high valuations.
Yeah, that's right, Heidi. And actually, one of the most read stories on our terminal over the past few hours is an interview that Bloomberg did with Daron Acemoglu. He is a renowned professor at MIT, and basically he's poured a lot of cold water over the potential of AI, because if you take a look at where AI stocks are trading, for instance, and this chart here puts it in perspective, you've got Nvidia, the line in white, but then you're also looking at Meta and Broadcom there. The line in purple is the S&P 500, and it has really, of course, been outpaced by those AI-related themes. Pretty much every single industry is talking about job disruptions to a degree. And Acemoglu tells us that this is completely overblown. He's saying that at best, only 5% of jobs are set to be replaced by the technology. So then it's really a question of, okay, where does that mania you're seeing there go from here? He's seeing sort of three different scenarios here. One is that it slowly fades. Two, we see the frenzy building for another year or so, and then you've got a tech stock crash. And three, he says that companies could end up continuing to invest heavily in AI for years. It goes unchecked. They push through layoffs. They're only left scrambling to rehire staff when the technology doesn't go as expected. And so he's looking at a sort of a combination of two and three as being the most likely scenario here. Again, a bit of pessimism being added to the mix, but it is interesting to put what Acemoglu is saying against that story around OpenAI raising $6.6 billion at a valuation of near $160 billion as well.